Barney, man. How you doing? Look out for me. You know what? I'm going to sing at the gate today. Yeah, I go tomorrow. Yeah, I'm good. I go tomorrow.
We have come to seek your face. Oh, Lord, you're welcome. Oh, Lord, you're welcome. You are welcome in this place. Sing
Good morning, St. John. Said I was glad when he said unto me, let's go into the house of the Lord, amen. My feet shall stand.
Lord, I'm down in this mean old world.
Need you in the hospital.
Come see about me.
Cause I'm down.
I'm
Somebody needs you right now,
come
Lord.
Come see about me.
Come on and see about me.
Come see about me.
Come on, Lord.
Come see about me.
Lord, we need you right now.
Come see about me.
Come on and see about me.
Come see about me.
Come on, Jesus.
Come see about me.
So let's go into the house of the Lord. Yes. Amen. Come on, put your hands together.
I'm glad I got Jesus. I got Jesus on my
right here in this place.
Lord,
you know it's good.
It's good to be here.
It's good.
It's good to be here.
My good.
It's good to be here.
Just to
give God praise.
I'm ready to take this thing on home now. I'm starting to feel pretty good. If you got the feels all down in your heart, and you know that God has truly gave you another chance to be in the house of the Lord, why don't y'all come on,
boy,
with us?
Come on, boy, come on now.
It's good.
It's good to be here.
It's good.
It's good to be here.
Mighty good.
It's good to be here.
It's good.
It's good to be here.
It's
Lord,
good.
It's good to be here.
It's good.
It's good to be here.
Mighty good.
It's good to be here.
It's good.
It's good to be here.
Let me see. Clap your
hands. It's good to be here.
And clap your hands.
It's good to be here.
Clap them a little bit louder.
It's good to be here.
It's good to be here.
It's good to be here.
I'm gonna sing my song.
It's good to be here.
It's good to be here.
It's good to be here.
I'm gonna clap my hands.
It's good to be here.
It's good to be here.
It's good to be here.
I could have been dead.
It's good to be here.
Sleeping in my grave.
It's good to be here.
I could have been lying.
It's good to be here.
On a bed of affliction.
It's good to be here.
But it's good to be here.
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 My good.
It's good to be here.
It's good.
It's good to be here.
A good, good God Almighty.
It's good to be here.
Good God Almighty.
It's good to be here.
A good, good God Almighty.
It's good to be here.
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 Look to your neighbor.
It's good to be here.
And tell your neighbor.
It's good to be here.
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 I'm glad to be in the service.
Yes, sir.
Service one more time. I'm glad I got Jesus. I got Jesus on my mind. I'm glad to be able to
see your smiling face.
I'm glad to be standing right here.
Lord, in this place.
You know it's good.
It's good to be here.
It's good.
It's good to be here.
Mighty good.
It's good to be here.
Just to
hear God to pray.
Yes, he is.
Let me good here. He's good.
It's good to be here.
It's good.
It's good to be here.
Mighty good.
It's good to be here.
It's 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 good.
It's good to be here.
My God.
It's good to be here. It's good to be here.
Mighty good.
It's good to be here.
Dance like David dance.
It's good to be here.
Come on,
David dance. It's good to be here.
Come on,
it's good to be here.
It's good to be here.
It's good to be here.
If you got joy,
it's good to be here.
Down in your heart,
it's good to be here.
You ought to be a celebrant.
It's good to be here.
It's good to be here.
It's good to be here.
A good, good God.
It's good to be here.
Good God Almighty.
It's good to be here.
Good, good God Almighty.
It's good to be here.
It's good to be here.
It's good to be here.
He picked me up.
It's good to be here.
Turned me all around.
It's good to be here.
Place my feet on.
It's good to be here.
Place them on solid ground.
It's good to be here.
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 I'm glad to be in the service. Service one more time. I'm glad I got Jesus. I got Jesus on my mind.
Well,
I'm glad to be able to
see your smiling face.
I'm glad to be standing right here in
Lord.
us do.
Give God the praise.
Here for my pulpit, give my hand as they come.
Let us stand for the call of worship. And truly, good morning, St. John's.
Good morning.
Truly, truly, it's good. It's good to be here. The psalmist says that we are to enter his gates with thanksgiving. We are to enter his courts with praise. And let me tell you why you have the reason to be thankful. Because God woke you up this morning. He gave you your right mind. He gave you a portion of your health and your strength. He said that terror came all night long, and the arrows are flying all day long. When the enemies came to eat up my flesh, they stumbled and they fell, and it was nobody, 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 nobody but the Lord. And we ought to be able to lift up holy hands and just say, thank you, God. But we just give God all the praise, because he and he alone is worthy of our praise. Let us pray. Holy Spirit, Holy Spirit, we welcome you in this place. We welcome you, Lord, to abide in our hearts and in our minds. We welcome you, Lord, to run from heart to heart, from breast to breast. We welcome you, Lord, just to have your way.
Yes.
Father God, in the precious name of Jesus, dear Lord, I pray this prayer in the matchless name of him who does all things well, Jesus the Christ, and everyone say with me, amen.
Good morning. Our scripture reading will be coming from the book of Joshua, chapter 24, beginning at verse 10. And it reads, "But I would not hearken unto Balaam, therefore he blessed you still. So I delivered you out of his hand. And he went over Jordan and came unto Jericho, and the men of Jericho fought against you. The Amorites, the Perizzites, and the Canaanites, and the Hittites, and the Girgashites, and the Hivites, and the Jebusites, and I delivered them into your hand. And I sent the hornet before you, which drave them out from before you, even the two kings of the Amorites, but not with thy sword, nor with thy bow. And I have given you a land for which ye did not labor, and cities which ye built not, and ye dwell in them, of the vineyards and olive yards which ye planted not do ye eat. Now therefore fear the Lord, and serve him in sincerity and in truth, and put away the gods which your father served on the other side of the flood and in Egypt, and serve ye the Lord. And if it seem evil unto you to serve the Lord, choose you this day whom whom you will serve, whether the gods which your fathers served that were on the other side of the flood, or the gods of the Amorites in whose land ye dwell. But as for me and my house, we will serve the Lord. And the people answered and said, God forbid that we should forsake the Lord to serve other gods. You may be seated in the presence of the Lord. Let us bow our heads in a word of prayer. Lord God, we thank you for the blood of Jesus. The blood of Jesus that allows us to draw near unto you. The blood of Jesus that cleanses us from all sin and all of our iniquities. Right now, we stand before you, God, without a single fault because of the blood of Jesus. Come before. It's not our mother and our father, God. It's not our sister and our brother, but it's me, oh Lord. And we are crying out to you, God. We're calling out unto you. God, we need you right now. We need you to come into the midst, God, of this service. We need you to touch each and every heart and mind. We need you, oh God, to touch our ears that we may hear from you, oh God, that we may receive a word from you. Let us not harden our hearts. Let us not be stubborn. Let us not be doubting. Let us not be unbelieving, oh God, but let us trust in you, the living God, with all of our hearts, with all of our minds, and with all of our souls. Help us, Heavenly Father. We need you, God. You didn't bring us this far to leave us, God. You didn't bring us this far to leave us. God, we thank you in advance. We thank you in advance for what you are about to do. We thank you for what you're doing right now. We ask that you would touch Dr. Jackson. Touch him from the crown of his head to the soles of his feet. Give him a word from on high. Let your word come forth with power and demonstration of your spirit. God, let somebody cry out, what must I do to be saved? Let somebody be healed today. Let somebody be delivered today. Let somebody be set free. God, in the name of Jesus, we are counting on you. We bind up every evil works of the enemy. In the name of Sandoroboso. In the name of Jesus, let your angels be encamped in the four corners of this church, for you know what your people need. We are your people. We are the sheep of your pasture, and you're able to do over and above all we can ask or think. We thank you in advance. We thank you in advance. We thank you in advance, God. In Jesus' name, amen.
By the smile that with the how do you do.
So in the morning
I'll meet you
early
in the morning
with the how.
With the how do you do.
We will sit down.
We will sit down
by the
river.
Old acquaintance.
Old acquaintance. In the morning, by the smile that I wear,
I'll meet you. Sit down.
We will sit down
by the river.
Old acquaintance. Old acquaintance. Be renewed.
Will you know me?
Will you know me?
Early
in the morning,
by the smile.
By the smile. In the morning,
I'll meet you.
I'll meet you
in the morning.
In the morning,
I'll meet you.
I'll meet you
in the morning.
In the morning,
I'll meet you.
I'll meet you
early in the morning.
In the morning,
in the morning,
in the morning,
God Almighty.
In the morning,
when the scepter.
In the morning. In the morning,
he's on morning.
In the morning,
be very long.
In the morning,
you're gonna look for me.
In the morning,
I'll be gone on home.
In the morning,
bring me up to glory.
In the morning,
where I'll sing and shout.
In the morning,
nobody up there.
In the morning,
you turn me out.
In the morning,
I'm gonna look up, David.
In the morning,
in the heat of the day.
In the morning,
won't you tune my heart?
In the morning,
I'm gonna play.
In the morning,
I'm gonna chat with the Father.
In the morning,
talk to the Son.
In the morning,
tell him about this world.
In the morning,
that I just come from.
In the morning,
clap your hands.
In the morning,
a little bit louder.
In the morning,
clap your hands.
In the morning,
a little bit louder.
In the morning,
while you're clapping your hands.
In the morning,
while you're clapping your hands.
In the morning,
I want to ask you one question.
In the morning,
I want to ask you one question.
In the morning,
how many want to see Jesus?
In the morning,
how many want to see Jesus?
In the morning,
how many want to see Jesus?
In the morning,
man who bled and died.
In the morning,
bled and died.
In the morning,
from 6 to the 9th hour.
In the morning,
laid his head.
In the morning,
and the locks of his shoulder.
In the morning,
he died.
In the morning,
tell you he died.
In the morning,
Jesus died.
In the morning,
yes he died.
In the morning,
laid him in the grave.
In the morning,
all night Friday.
In the morning,
he stayed in the grave.
In the morning,
all day Saturday.
In the morning,
one thing I wanna tell you.
In the morning,
one thing I wanna tell you.
In the morning,
early.
In the morning,
one Sunday morning.
In the morning,
he got up.
In the morning,
he got up.
In the morning,
he got up.
In the morning,
all power in his hand.
In the morning,
I wanna see him.
In the morning,
I wanna see him.
In the morning,
I wanna see him.
In the morning,
I wanna see Jesus.
In the morning,
hey.
In the morning, in the morning.
How many want to see the Lord?
In the morning.
I mean, you truly want to see God.
In the morning.
Well,
in the morning.
Good God Almighty.
In the morning.
Good God Almighty.
In the morning.
Early in the morning.
In the morning. In the morning,
good God.
In the morning,
good God.
In the morning,
good God Almighty.
In the morning,
well,
in the morning,
feeling well.
In the morning,
feeling well.
In the morning,
feeling well.
In the morning,
I wanna see it.
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 In the morning,
I'ma chat with the Father.
In the morning,
talk to the hand.
In the morning,
I'ma ask you one question.
In the morning,
I wanna ask you one question.
In the morning,
how many wanna see Jesus?
In the morning,
how many wanna see Jesus?
In the morning,
how many wanna see Jesus?
In the
man who laid and died.
In the morning,
laid and died.
In the morning,
from 6 to 9 hours.
In the morning,
laid his head.
In the morning,
in the locks of his shoulder.
In the morning,
Jesus died.
In the morning,
Jesus died.
In the morning,
well, he died.
In the morning, in the morning,
early.
In the morning,
one Sunday morning.
In the morning,
he got up.
In the morning,
he got up.
In the morning,
he got up.
In the morning,
all power in his hand.
In the morning,
I wanna see him.
In the morning,
I wanna see him.
In the morning.
Put your hands together for our very own pastor, Dr. Daryl Jackson.
Yeah! 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 Praising the Lord. Yes, I want to see Jesus when I get to heaven. That's the first one I want to see. The one that died for my sin. Because I wasn't all that. I didn't come here wearing a robe, but God brought me. He picked me up, turned me around. How many know I was on my way to a devil's hell? But God picked me up in the nick of time. And I am so glad about that. And I don't mind telling the world. I don't mind telling you. I got Jesus on my mind. When I woke up this morning, I was glad to be able to breathe. You know, I get out of bed on my own strength. Didn't nobody have to lift me up. I put my own clothes. You know I'm happy. You know I'm praising the Lord this morning. You don't miss your water till your well run dry. So if you can't praise God from getting up in the morning on your own, and listen, you didn't have to walk to church. You come up in here driving. And when you got up at home at the house, you didn't have to go out and carry no water in to wash your face. You didn't have to do that. You got hot and cold water right there. Now you ought to be praising the Lord now. Because if you come back in my day, you had to go outside and gather up the water. And you didn't have no running water in the house unless you spill it on the floor. Then it run across the floor. You didn't have no pipe. So when you see me stand up, I'm showing up happy. I'm good to be here. Listen. Let's go to God in a moment of prayer. Gracious Lord, Father God, it's preaching time. And I thank you, Lord, for the word you have pregnated me with, that I be able to deliver it to your people, that you may be glorified, Father, and they may be saved. Have your way in this service today. In Jesus' perfect and pure name we pray. Amen. Amen. If you start off right, good chance you can end up right. And so I always want to start off with the Lord on my side. Amen? How many are ready for a word today? How many need a word today? You need some word to get you through the next week. Something you can hold on to. And I want you to know this, that within my messages, I want you to look and find yourself in the message that you can prosper from and grow from and get strength from. Find yourself in these messages. And so we're going to go to the book of Joshua for my text. It's the 24th chapter and the 14th and the 15th verse for a text. Taking glasses off to read. Let me see. Now, therefore, fear the Lord and serve him in sincerity and in truth, and put away the gods which your fathers served on the other side of the flood and in Egypt, and serve ye the Lord. And if it seems evil unto you to serve the Lord, choose you this day whom ye will serve, whether the gods which your fathers served on that were on the other side of the flood, or the gods of the Amorites in whose land ye dwell. But look at him. But as for me, in my house, we gonna serve the Lord. But as for me, in my house, we gonna serve the Lord. And I want to use for a subject of thought. What is your choice? What is your choice? What is your choice? But as for me, in my household, you hear me good now. As for me, I'm going to stay with the Lord. And you know, whenever you're making choices, make sure you pick the right one. You know, we have choices in life, and whatever you're picking, make sure you know what you're picking. You know, there was a songwriter some years ago say it takes time. It's some older folks have to know this. It takes time to know her. It's not an overnight. Not an overnight thing. So doing your picking, you have to know what you are picking. Even a boyfriend. Watch him. Take time to know him. Pick him carefully. Girlfriend, pick him carefully. Don't just jump up there and pick anyone. Pick him prayerfully. And I know when I pick my wife, we've been picking together for 50 years, so we still picking. So, but I picked her carefully. And one of her attributes when I picked her, when we go out different places, you know, she didn't even look for me to go in my pocket all the time. She, oh, I got this. I said, you do? Oh, go ahead. And so all of these, some of these attributes, I said, okay, she's a keeper. It's a work here. And so, but know what you are picking and know who you are picking. But looking at our text today, we see where Moses has led the people right next door to the promised land. And these people still had brick dust from the Egyptians still in their clothes. And Moses was about ready to be put to sleep. Because God put Moses to sleep in the plains of Moab, put him to sleep, because Moses had performed his job. So he put Moses to sleep. And Moses had already set up Joshua to run the race. And Moses told Joshua, just as the Lord was with me. In other words, he'll be with you.
And so Joshua is at the helm now. He is leading the people. He carried them across the Jordan River. And he brought them through Jericho. You get the battle of Jericho. And the walls came tumbling down. Even Ai, Joshua took care of Ai. And they all come tumbling down. Now, Joshua is now ready to come down to the end. He's ready to make his farewell address. Joshua is 110 years old. He have done what thus says the Lord. And so he's meeting in the valley of Shechem. The valleys of Shechem. And this valley where they are meeting is very important because Abraham's residue is still in this valley. Because Abraham built an altar in the valley of Shechem. In other words, Jacob, Rebecca, Isaac bones are carried to this valley called Shechem. And so when Joshua get all the people there, because he done brought them as far as he can bring them. And now it's time for them to make a decision. You see, it come a time when you got to make a decision what you're going to do. Am I right about it? And so Joshua is bringing him to the test. And even if you read the book of Joshua, the 24th chapter, you will see, I didn't go back as far, but the 24th chapter, it takes them on back to when they was in Egypt. How they cried out to God, and God sent them Moses there. You know, when the children of God start crying out to their father, God will answer them. That's why it is so important not to mess with a child of God. If you don't know what you're doing, you better leave a child of God alone. Because the Bible plainly tells you, you might have a millstone tied around your neck, thrown into the sea. Especially if one come crying and hollering to me. I got four daughters. And they're old now. But if one of them come crying to me, here come daddy, daddy coming. And if I can come to their rescue to see what's wrong, how much more can God come? And so Joshua is pulling them down to this point that you need to make a choice. In other words, I've been with you. But why are you making this choice? Joshua is giving them some good information. So when you start adding stuff up, let's balance this thing out. Joshua starts out, wait a minute, who woke you up? Who got you started? And who have blessed you from where you are now? In other words, Joshua said, let me remind you, he's been a way maker for you. Am I right about that? Joshua said, when you was in the wilderness and when you got hungry, you didn't have no food or bread. He rained down manna from on high. And then when you got thirsty, he in a dry country with nothing but rocks around, He brought water from a rock. And Joshua said, wait a minute, hold up. Even when you was traveling in the daytime, the sun shining bright, he had a pillar of cloud over your head. Even in the nighttime when you couldn't see, he had a pillar of fire by night watching over you. And look, your sandals, you still look like they're new. These 40-year-old sandals, they're looking new. God ain't let nothing wear out. Now, Joshua is breaking it off real good to him. So if you're going to make a choice, you're going to have to make a sensible choice, a real good choice. Because Joshua said, he put food on your table. He made your enemies around, turn your enemies around. He fought the battle for you. Jericho, all those names that Minister Reagan read out today was fighting against you, but I gave you the power to overcome them. Because if anybody know, if God be for you, who can be against you? So Joshua is letting them know and stacking the cards so they'll be on the right page. You see, when you didn't have a job, he let them know that, I'm talking to y'all now, when you didn't have a job, and then your house still there, your house wasn't taken, you're still in the same place, had food on your table, God took care of you. Do I have anybody in the house that can witness with me, that have gone through ups and, ups and downs? Do I have anybody? When it looked like things was falling apart, God stepped in right in the midst of time, picked me up, turned me around. Am I right about it? And then many, all of us now can go into the closet at house, at home, we have to push loose stuff to see what am I going to wear. Take this out, that out. I ain't going to wear that, I'm going to wear this. Shoes stacked up all over the closet. Am I right about it? Do I have any real folk in the house? You ought to be able to praise God. God did it. God did it. God did it. And then he come up here driving a car. God did it. God did it. Am I right about it? You see, it don't take much to get happy. It don't take much to get stirred up. When you know where you came from, when you know what you used to have, and what you have now, John, it don't take much. It don't take much to praise the Lord. I remember when I just had a bicycle. Don't take much to praise the Lord. But even before a bicycle, I mean when I just walking. But now I can. And you know I'm going to praise the Lord. And if they get tired driving the cat, I jump in the truck. Won't God do it? And if I get tired of the truck, I get the Avalon my wife got. No, she say no. But to God, how he has blessed us, picked us up. Am I right about it? And in other words, when I think about myself, I need to go back to myself and think about what God has done. See, when I was a little boy, every Sunday morning was church time. It wasn't asking, didn't nobody come in there. Grandmama didn't come in and say, Dara, do you want to go to church? That wasn't even in the vocabulary. Sunday morning, because grandmama wouldn't even cook on Sunday. They would do all their cooking on Saturday and do all their ironing. Now, we was happy when we got an iron that was electric. I guess I had to go back way back. Some of these folks don't know about them other kind of iron. See, the other kind of iron, you had to make a fire for them to get hot. But see, how God has blessed you and just stepped you on up. But it wasn't no ironing on Sunday morning. You went to church, stayed all day. And they didn't give you no little piece of cookie or piece of candy in church to keep you quiet. All they had was an eye. They'd look at you. They had an eye, and they just look at you. And you knew what that signal means. And you would shut up, be quiet, and sit still. But that's the way I came up. Respecting the Lord. And knowing that God got my back. No matter what I'm going through. Am I right about that? You see, when God has blessed you, and you can drive what you want, and you can live where you can afford. But God has been better than that. I know when God has blessed me with a healing that I was sick. God took care of me. He healed my body. When my body had cancer, God removed the cancer. And that ain't been no 5 years ago. That's been 20-something years ago. Am I right about it? Am I walking all right? Am I walking all right? Won't he do it? Won't he do it? And so I don't mind Psalms 30 and 5. Weeping may endure for a night, but joy comes in the morning. Joy comes in the morning. But I'm gonna show he was better than that. On one Friday evening, he went to the cross. He was better than that. They stuck him in the side. They put a crown of 72 thorns on his head. He was better than that. You know, he didn't say a mumbling word. He didn't say a mumbling, but he could have got off the cross. But he was better than that. He stayed on the cross, but he was better than that. He stayed on the cross for you, me. That's why I'm here today, because he stayed on the cross. He was better than that. But when they put him in the ground, put him in a borrowed tomb, and they put him in there, and he stayed one day. But he had already told them, if you destroy this temple, you can tear it up. 3 days. 3 days it's coming back. And they didn't believe it. He stayed in the grave all day, the first day. Nothing happened. I can imagine in my spiritual mind. That part was questioning. Satan, do you still have him? Satan said, I got Moses. I got Abraham. I got Noah. I got Noah's family. I ain't lost nobody. Okay? Second night. I can imagine the question went out again. Satan, do you still got it? But he talking about getting up in 3 days. Oh, I got them all. He said, I got David. I got Joshua. I got Mary. I got them all. I got them all. Ain't nobody leaving here. So he stayed in there the third day. But how many know early that Sunday morning, my God got up out of that grave. He's better than that with all power in his hand. Am I right about it? Won't he do it? Satan said, what's wrong? You can't hold him. Jesus said, turn me loose. Ain't no grave can hold this body down. I'm getting up out of here. Just as I say. But he's better than that. He's better than that. Because the Bible says there is more. God will wipe away all our tears. God is wiping away all our tears. There's more. God will wipe away all our sickness. There'll be no more death. There'll be no more heartaches. But wait a minute. He's better than that. They looked in the Bible. John saw. He saw a crowd of folk coming from the north. And then he looked around again. He was a crowd of folks coming from the south. And he kept on looking. And there was a crowd of folks coming from the east. There's a crowd of folks coming from the west. And somebody asked a question, who are they? And the question was answered. These are they who had gone through great tribulation. They had on their white robes. I don't know about you, but I'm going to be with the Lord. I'm coming one day. He's on my side one day. Am I right about it? Am I right about it? Tell somebody that you're going to be with the Lord. Tell somebody you're going to be with the Lord. I don't know about you, but I made my choice. My choice is to stay with the Lord. I don't know which way you're going to go, but my choice is going to stay with the Lord. You better stay with the one that builds you up. You better stay with the one that does not die. You better stay with the one that can answer prayer. Am I right about it? I told you how to get a prayer answered. You got to keep the lines open. Keep your prayer lines open. In other words, keep them open by asking God to forgive you every day and throughout the day. Keep your lines open so you can get a prayer line through. I'm going to stay with the Lord. I'm going to stay with the Lord. Because he'll answer your prayer. He'll talk to you. He'll say that, baby, I love you. He'll let you know that. And a lot of this, we say, that wasn't my choice. But who's in control? How many know God's in control? And by knowing that, I'm going to take you to John 14. Let not your heart be troubled. Because he said, if you believe in God, he said, believe in me also. Because in my Father's house, there are many of mansions. And Jesus said, if it were not so, I would have told you. And he said, I go. And if I go to prepare a place for you, I'm going to come again and receive you unto myself. That where I am, you will be also. And Thomas said, Lord, we know not where thou goest. How are we going to know the way? I can imagine Jesus stood up boldly, flat-footed. I am the way, the truth, and the life. No man come to the Father except by me. I hope you're making the right choice. Hope the choice is in God's favor. Because remember, if God be for you, who can be against you? I don't care who get in the chair, the president's chair. I'm not worried about that. I vote for who I thought should be in there. But if God didn't allow it, so be it. My hope is built on nothing less. My hope is built on nothing less. Jesus' blood and righteousness. I dare not trust the sweetest frame, but wholly lean on Jesus' name. Woo! On Christ, solid rock I stand. All of the ground is sinking sand. Am I right about it? Do I have any believers in the house like that? Amen. You stay with the Lord. What's your choice? Don't worry about man. Man can't do nothing. Don't you know Trump? I didn't mean to say it, but don't you know? Pray for me. Help me, Lord. Pray for me. Don't you know no president can do nothing without the Lord giving him the strength? Now, if God give him the strength to do whatever he's going to do, amen. Because, see, I already know what John 3:16 says. It says, for God, and I'm in the world. And so if he loved me, he loved the world. Whatever he give him to do, I'm still in the love game. So he's going to take care of me. And before I ended up, I got a feeling, a spiritual feeling, that those who are Bible readers, you know about the time when Egypt was about to get into a famine situation. And Joseph became second in command in Egypt. And Joseph sent for all his folk. Come on down here where I am. I'm moving fast with it. Come on down here where I am. He brought him on down there. Put him on a little section of Egypt called Goshen. Put him in that section. And don't you know that little section flourished? They had great livestock. They had great vegetables. They were multiplying fast with people and kids. God blessed them. You know, because he told, who did he tell? I will prepare a table before you in the presence of your enemies. And you know, we can be going through hard times. A recession could be going on. I can be sitting in my house with my legs crossed, just got through eating the steak. And get another one in there to eat tomorrow. Because God, the kind of God I serve, he can do that. But let me stop talking now. What is your choice? Your choice should be with Christ. Virtual God, but we got one God. Three, but all one. And he can do all of that stuff in one. Am I right about it? See, I don't mind sharing what I know. And he brought me through so much. In church, I'm not talking about what somebody said. I'm not talking about what I read. I'm talking about the blessing God has blessed me with. And I'm still getting blessed from it. And I can say one thing. If you be obedient to God, He will take care of you. Pay your tithes. And I know in one of my classes the other day, we was talking about that. And I said how I used to work in construction and had my own construction business. I said, Lord, now this ain't going to work in the church. Now I got all these trucks and tractors and all this stuff. And the money of the church folk, they ain't gonna match up. This ain't gonna work here, Lord. And the Lord said to me, Daryl, I made the church. I made the tractors you got. You go on and do what I asked you to do, Pastor. And God knows, I've been more places, seen more, done more with less money. Ain't been hungry. God will make a way. God will make a way. Follow Him. Follow Him. Right now, I want to open these doors of the church. If those out there in the media ministry are watching, and maybe you've been going through with trials and tribulations and ups and downs, and you've been planning on giving your life to Christ, You've been saying you're going to do it, but each time you get ready to do it, something happens. But God has allowed you this day. If you're listening to me wherever you are, and you want to give your life to Christ, I want you to pray this prayer with me. Pray this prayer with me. If you are a sinner, and you want to give your life to Christ, you've got so much problems. Many times we have issues and problems that we try to shake off ourselves. And we can't shake them off. So we have to take them to God. And Jesus will take you just as you are. So pray this prayer with me. Our Father, which art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Lord Jesus, it's me standing in the need of salvation. Lord, I want to go to heaven when I leave this world. And Lord Jesus, I understand that I haven't done all that I'm supposed to do. I haven't done all that you told me to do. You told me to go left and I went right. I messed up, Lord. But Lord, you said in your word, whosoever call upon the name of the Lord shall be saved. And I believe, Lord Jesus, you died for my sins. And I believe that God the Father raised you up from the dead. And I believe that my confession turns into salvation. If you prayed that prayer with me, your confession turns into salvation. You are saved. And I want you to give me a call. Well, you and I can talk and we can get some things straightened out that need to be straightened out. I can give you some sense of directions and what direction you need to go in and what need to take place next. You can be a distant member and I can direct you to those paths. But call me, Pastor Dr. Daryl Jackson, 704-864-6222, extension 208. Now, if I'm not there, please, ma'am, please, sir, leave it on the answering machine, and I will definitely get it, and I will return that call of the true and living King. Talking about a King that never died, a King that never lost, a King that's all seeing, a King that's everywhere at the same time. I want to turn you on to Him. Let me know, and we'll be glad to do that. And if you're there and you would like to support this ministry here at St. John's, I'm going to give you ways that you can support it. And God will continue to bless you This is fertile ground here. This is fertile ground. If you invest in this, give and it shall be given unto you. Ways you can give is you can bring cash, bring it to the church. You can bring a check, bring it to the church. Or you can go by PayPal or go through Giblify. And if you go by letter or check and you want to write a check and mail it, write it to St. John's Missionary Baptist Church, 1282 Bradford Heights Road, Gastonia, North Carolina, 28054. And then at the end of the year, when you need a tax write-off, you can come to the church and get a tax write-off from your donations you have given to this church. Now, let me tell you this. We need your support, but we are being supported by God. And God used people like you to help support. But if you choose not to support, God's church is not going to fail. Because Jesus said, upon this rock, I build my church. And the gates of hell shall not prevail. Doesn't mean the gates of hell won't blow against it. It may make it weave in the wind, but it won't come tumbling down. Because we are supported by the back of God. But if you want to be blessed for helping to build the kingdom of God, give to God's kingdom building, and God will open up doors for you. You see, it's a principle. You receive by giving. Give and you shall receive. That's one of the principles of God. We want you to know that we love you, we praise you, and thank God for you. Right now, we'll get ready for our, let's see here. Do we have any announcements coming up? My eyes are getting better, but they ain't not that good. Let's see. St. John Missionary Baptist Church Christmas program planning meeting will be held next Sunday, immediately after service, in the Outreach Center. All are welcome to attend. For any question, please contact Sister Teresa Richardson at 803-221-5293. So, Sister Richardson, if you would stand where these folks can see, because it might be somebody that just got here and don't see you. This is Miss Richardson. Deaconess Richardson. See her. Amen. Please see the program for any other announcement. At this time, I'm going to ask Brother Lane and his wife, they got some announcement for the couples ministry.
All right, good morning, church. We'd like to thank God for this opportunity again. Thank you, Pastor Jackson, for allowing us to come up. First of all, I really would like to say thank you to all of the couples that are joining and participating in the events that we do monthly. It's really growing, even the conversations after the sessions. I think that's really been a good thing, too, and then also just the fellowship that we have with one another. Sometimes it's nothing wrong with church, but sometimes you have to let your hair down a little bit. Let's relax. Let's talk as real people, real things that we can communicate about. And that's one of the things that we've actually worked on and really proud of. So at this point, we have an event going on in December that Denise has all the details on all of it.
Yes, so church and especially our couples, we have a Christmas social, and this is going to be at the Outreach Center, and this is December the 7th, and it's from 4 to 6, and again, I know women, we like to know, what do you want me to wear? So I thought it would be nice to do the ugly Christmas sweater, or either you can do that with some Western boots. Okay, so whatever your taste and feel, do you. Also, we want to make sure that you know that we do have a sign-up sheet which is at the back of the church. And please sign up for appetizer or dessert. And then also, we want to make sure that you remember to bring a $10 gift. And this is a gift, a wrap gift, and this is for our Dirty Santa gift exchange. Now, the couples will know more when you get there, which is going to be fun, but just make sure it's wrapped. And then we will not have a meeting in November, because we have the meeting in December, the 7th.
Okay.
Yes, we have a QR code that's also at the back. If it's easier for you just to do the QR code to let us know what you're going to bring. So thank you so much.
Thank you. Thank you for the couples ministry. You know, with the couples ministry, it's about like your bank account. You got to make more deposits than you make withdrawals in order to keep it running, to keep it rolling. Because with a bank statement, you make more withdrawals than you make deposits. It's gonna soon run out. So, but I've been making more deposits with Miss J than I did with the bank. So you make more deposits. So that's why we still rolling along 50 years that we rolling along. I'm going to ask my apple of the eye if she just stand up. Apple, please stand up. Let the folks see you. We've been doing it 50 years. Yeah. I'm going to stay with her. Ain't no love like my baby love. All right. I'm going to leave it alone. Okay. Sister Watson, you had missionary? But thank you. Yeah. Now you want to walk where you want to go as far, you can stop right here, Greg, save you some steps.
Okay, thank you. Good afternoon, church. This missionary announcement is short. This year, the missionary for their December project, we are going to make up gift bags for the seniors at St. John who are 75 and up. So anyone, male or female, that is 75 years old and up, there is a sign-up sheet near Dr. Jackson's office. If you'll put your name so that we can know the count of how many bags we need to prepare, try to do it today. I will leave it up to next Sunday. And after church next Sunday, if the missionary can just meet right over here so I can just tell you how many seniors we need to prepare for, I would really appreciate it. God bless.
Thank you, Sister Donna, for those words of encouragement. I am happy to see, Reverend Little John's in the house today. He's back with us, and anything you need to say, Little John? I know you've been doing the bus thing.
I'm just happy that it was good to be here, like the song said.
It's good to be here, okay. Good to be here. Good to have you here. And as I scan over the congregation, I see Sister Pearl's in the house. And not only did I see Sister Pearl in the house, but I see Sister Pearl's daughter and son-in-law in the house. Danny and Tammy's in the house. All my visitors, y'all stand and say something. I'm going to give you a mic where you can talk if you want to holler. Healthy young man. Okay. Okay.
Jamal Little John.
Oh, okay.
Pastor Little John's son. I'm visiting for the first time. I'm enjoying myself.
Okay, you enjoyed yourself? Yes, good. We enjoyed you being here.
Thank you.
All right. Do I have any other visitors in the house? Right here. Okay, I'm coming. Yes, ma'am. We're glad to have you with us today. And anytime our doors are open here at St. John, we are certainly glad. What you like to say, sweetheart?
How y'all doing? My name is Crystal Lewis, and I'm visiting with my aunt, attending to this church.
Uh-huh.
And then my kids.
Okay, okay. So how do you enjoy being here today?
It was a good service. Thank you, Jesus.
Okay, okay, all right. Anyone else? Okay, one. Okay. I was right there beside you, girl.
This is my mother. You don't want to say nothing, though. This is my mother.
But just say hello, sweetheart.
Hello, my name is Mary Jingle Scott. I'm glad to be here today.
We're glad you're here. Amen, amen. Anybody else here that would like to say a word? But anytime our doors are open here at St. John, we are really, really glad to have you being a part of our service to help us to lift up the name of our Lord and Savior, Jesus the Christ. So it makes it a glorious time when all of us are on the same page giving our Lord and Savior praises. How many know when praises go up, blessings come down? And we are so thankful about that. At this time, we're going to boil down to pastors. No, I'm going to get to altar prayer. Then I'm going to come to the pastor's observation, the altar prayer. Altar prayer. And I'm going to let you stay in your seats because at one time, COVID was trying to spike up. We don't have to hold hands. You can hold your own hand. You can put your hand together and hold your own hand. And I'm going to ask my preacher, Reverend Little John, will you come and give us an altar prayer? And just as we get ready to pray, let's pray for ourselves, pray for our country, pray for Donald Trump and his cabinet, pray for Kamala Harris. Let's pray. Let's do our part because God got this and we're under a mandate to be Christ-like. And not to be, because we got another side of us too now that we try to keep down. So we have to keep prayed up on that one because they try to rise up every once in a while. But after we get through with the praying, the pastor's observation, I got a praise report that I want to share with y'all today that when I got this praise report over the phone, we hollered and yelled and like we was going crazy. But I'm going to tell you.
When I ask everybody to stand, is there any prayer requests? You know, it's good to know that we have an omnipotent God. And his omniscience is so powerful that we all can call out prayers. And he can hear us at the same time. And we believe because we have the faith that brings forth greatness in everything that we speak about. So today we ask you to bow your heads. Father God, we thank you for the time here today, God, praising your name, God. But God, we know, Lord, that without you, God, there's nothing that can be done. And God, we humbly come to you now, God, in the name of Jesus. Father God, we pray that you give us, God, understanding, God, how to press into you like we've never pressed before. Father God, we're praying, God, Lord, for a season such as this, God. Where, God, these motions that goes on, God, it brings emotional roller coasters in our minds, God. But, Father, in the name of Jesus, God, give your people the strength, God, to bring forth, God, through this time of struggle. Father God, in the name of Jesus, God, we believe that your power is present in this place. Father God, I pray, God, Lord, that you bring forth families, God. Hallelujah, God, that will bring forth, God, a declaration to you, God, like never before, God. God, we pray for all the requests, God. Everybody that spoke up, God. Every family, God. Oh, God, every son, every daughter, God. Oh, God, every grandchild, God. Every grandfather, God. Oh, God, every grandmother, God. Every mama, God. Every father, God. Father, in the name of Jesus, God. Oh, God, bring forth the clarity of this season. Oh, God, we need a move in this season, God. Bring forth the clarity, God. Oh, God, soothe us with the anointing, God. Anoint our minds afresh, God. Oh, God, give us the love that we need, God, to be able, God, to cover every sin that will come in our midst. Father God, Lord, we thank you for the visitors to today, God. God, we thank you, God, Lord, for the families today, God. God, we thank you, God, for being in the midst today, God. Father, we thank you, God, for our pastor today, God. God, we thank you, God, for, God, the men, God, that sung in the choir today, God. God, we're thankful, God, for every piece of the church. Father God, I pray, God, for clarity and humility, God, for your people, God, in Jesus' name. Amen. Glory to God.
Amen. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you.
Brother Adrian, you want to say something?
Yeah, good morning, church. It's good to be back. I'd just like to say I appreciate all the phone calls I got last week. And rest was needed. The Energizer Bunny ran out of energy, so... I'm back and my voice is a little better, but I'd like to announce the new gospel choir that we're starting with. We'll have rehearsal tomorrow at 6:45. So that's for everybody. It's a lot of few people that came up to me and said they would like to be able to sing, and this allows you to be able to sing. We're going to make a big group corporately, and we're going to give, I do all kinds of music. I'm not just one-sided. But I'm going to give you a little something that what you like and a little something different. So the ones that want to participate, if you can come out tomorrow night at 6:45, I would gladly appreciate it. And Pastor, I told my buddy I got some people that I done asked to join the men's choir.
Oh, really? Okay.
And he keep telling me to give him the box. So I got to give you the box.
I think it's still working. Reggie, right there. Now, you say he can't sing. I got the box ready for you.
Okay, all right.
But to God be the glory. All that will, come see me after church, and I'll see y'all tomorrow night.
Amen. Thank you. Thank you, Brother Adrian, for that information and those words. Don't forget to keep all of our sick and shut in your prayers. Remember Sister Ollie Patton, Sister Valora Cook, Brother Paul Acker. Remember Sister Emma Glenn. I was by to see Sister Emma. She's needing a procedure, but she's trying to get it organized. But keep Sister Emma Glenn, Nadine Glenn, in your prayers. And I was by to see Sister Pam Sanders. They was right in the same place together. Matter of fact, I think you, Sister Spears, you was on the phone when I was in one of them's offices. Right, right. But anyway, keep them in your prayers. Also, Sister Michelle Miller. Sister Michelle Miller, she's not in the house, but keep her in your prayers, too. She's one of our ushers. And also, not only her, but Sister Shanita Sanders. Keep Sister Shanita in the house. Shanita, stand up. Let somebody look at you, girl. You in the house. Okay, all right. Thank God for that. Shanita's in the house. Thank you so much. Keep Sister Sarah Presley in your prayers. Keep her in your prayers. And let's pray for Sister Bessent, Uretha Bessent. Keep her in your prayers. Miss Maggie Smith. Just pray for those, even if I didn't name them, keep them in your prayers as well. Because that's what we're supposed to do, is to pray for one another. But let me tell you this. Are you ready for the announcement that we've been praying for? And it finally showed up. I was minding my own business at church this past week. And if you had heard my office, you would have thought somebody had lost their life in there. A young man on the phone said, "Pastor." And it had, I looked at my phone and it had Ozella's precious number on it, name on it. I said, "Hey, this voice is much too deep for Ozella's voice." And so I was listening. He said, "Pastor."
"Pastor, I'm Sterling."
"Sterling, hey Sterling, how you doing?" He said, "Guess what? I've been accepted in the United States Air Force." Woo! Won't he do it? We about went crazy praising him on the phone. And he said that I'm supposed to go to Texas, but I want to go before it get too hot. He said, "Because you might not know my complexion if I get out there in the summertime." But anyway, we was thankful for that because he had a little setback because he was injured. And they couldn't get in there earlier when he wanted to. But God. Woo! "And they that wait on the Lord shall renew their strength." So, but thank God for that. Also, this past Saturday, we have finished all the ordination classes, and we have one that's in our midst that's going to be ordained, and that's going to be on the 7th of December down to Center Baptist. And we had all of our other ministers that go through the classes. Minister Reagan went through the ordination classes. So she's going to have everything she needs. So if there come a need for ordained, she won't have to go through no classes. We can just pull the council together and ordain her. But Sister Janice, she's going to be ordained. And it's, you know, we lost, huh? The 7th of December, 5:30 at Center Baptist, 5:30 on that date. Yep. So she's going to be ordained because, you know, we had just lost one ordained preacher. That was Diana Johnson. So the Lord called her from labor to reward. So we had to let that one go. But to God be the glory for the great thing that he has done. So anything, Sister Denise, you'd like to say? I mean, Sister Janice, you good?
Thank you, God.
Okay. Yeah. All right. At this time, I'm going to ask are we good? Yeah, anyone here that would like to give their life to Christ? Thank you for joining the church. Do I have any joiners here that would like to join? You can come by letter, come by Christian experience, or come by way of baptism. Do I have anyone that want to give their life to Christ?